applied to Amazon 6 to 7 times for referrals. I never got a call, right? And after a few days, I got a call directly from the recruiter. Hey guys, I'm Riddhi Datta and I'm a software engineer at Amazon. And in this video, I'm going to talk about referral process. So in this video, I'm going to give you a walkthrough of the entire referral process of all the top product-based companies, right? So that all your confusion regarding how a referral process works, how can you apply for referrals effectively, right? And how which are the persons you should reach out for referrals. And I'm going to discuss all these questions. I'm going to answer all these questions or clear all your doubts in this one video. So make sure that you watch this video till the very end. So without any further ado, let's get started. So in this video, I'm going to talk about a step-by-step procedure about referrals and all the questions I think that you guys have around this entire referral process at this product-based companies will be answered. If not, then don't forget to comment down your question and I will be more than happy to resolve your doubts, right? Having said that, now let's come to the first step of the referral process. So a common mistake that I've seen a lot of students and employees doing is they tend to reach out to any random person on LinkedIn and they're just asking that, hey, do you have any active openings in your company, right? Now you have to understand this thing. This might work for some cases, but you have to understand that he's just an employee at the company, right? So he might not be aware of the active openings that exist in his company, right? Even as an Amazon employee, I don't know that what are the SD1 openings right now, because it's very unlikely that I'm going to check the job portals every day because I might be busy in my own day-to-day responsibilities and job, right? So what you need to do is you need to do the homework, right? You need to find out the job IDs and then text the employee that, hey, please refer me to this particular job ID and these are my relevant skills and this is my CV, right? So this is the way you should text. Now, how do you procure the job IDs, right? That's a very important question. So what you need to do is, let's say you want to apply for Microsoft. So you go to careers.microsoft.com. So basically that is the career page, right? And then you try to filter out that, let's say you are applying for a software engineering position and you want to apply for a level 60 role and you have 1 to 2 years of experience, right? So what you would do is you would filter the position in which you want to apply for, right? Now make sure that don't unnecessarily try to apply or take referrals for positions where you yourself know that you do not match to the years of experience that would require out of you or the skills do not match you. So please take that in mind. Otherwise, it would be a waste of time for both you and the person who's referring you. Now, keeping this in mind, if you come across any job positions or any job roles that you seem to be a good fit for, then note down the job IDs, right? Job ID. And what you would do is you would now go on LinkedIn, right? And you would text that person that, hey, please refer me for this particular job ID at your company, right? And that person, and also write 2 or 3 lines about yourself, that why are you a good fit for the role. That really, really helps. And then send your CV, right? So moving forward to the rest of this video, let me introduce you to Code Studio, which is a free platform by coding ninjas. So the one interesting thing about which I like about this platform is basically if you're solving problems on LeetCode, right? And if you don't have a LeetCode premium account, which we need to pay some bucks for, what happens is, let's say you're solving a question, but you are not sure exactly like this question came in under which company, or let's say if you're having some interviews, right, scheduled for, let's say, a company like Microsoft, you just can't go and like find the questions under Microsoft if you don't have the LeetCode premium account. But Code Studio solved this problem for you, and it has like all the company tag questions free of cost. So let's say also when you're solving a question, you see that LC of 3 nodes, this question came in Amazon, Microsoft, Ambient Express and all the companies. You also get, you know, questions tagged with TCS and all the other service-based companies as well. So basically you get all the LeetCode premium things, most of the LeetCode premium things free over here, right? Also, you can see that you can find the top problem list. You get like DSS sheet problems. So let's say if I want to open LoveBubble's DSS sheet, then you can see that you get all the sheet questions, and also you would be able to solve them over here as well. So that's a great thing. Also, there's content on DBMS, system design, operating system, right? And also there are 2000 plus problems or interview problems of all product-based companies, from great startups like Zomato, Ola, to all the big companies like Amazon and Microsoft, as I already told you. Also, the solutions for all the interview problems are available in all the 3 languages like C++, Java and Python. So the platform is language independent and you don't need to worry about it. And also, let me show you another great
feature of this course studio is, like, you see there are a lot of interview experiences. So there are around 600 plus interview experiences of all the companies, right? And it has a very unique feature where you will be able to attempt every problem as an interview experience from there itself, right? So it's not only that you're reading the problem, you'll be also able to go and solve those interview experiences, and that will help you really feel confident before any interview that is scheduled for you, right? You can also attempt popular list of problems on the platform. Like one I showed you, that is LoveBubba's DSA sheet. Also, you can attempt like the Cracking the Coding Interview book, which is a very, very popular book of cracking coding interviews. And also, as I told you earlier in this video, you can also attempt questions like top Microsoft coding interview questions or top array coding interview questions, something which you would not get in Lead Code in a normal version. You have to pay for it, but here you get it completely free. So do go and check it out. I will attach the link to this down in description below. And now let's continue with the video.
So now, by doing this, what happens is that person who has to refer you has now the explicit job ID with him, right? So what he can do is he can go, you can log into his portal, right? And he can search by the job ID and then he can refer you, right? So this is the step one. Do your homework, procure all the job IDs that you wish to apply for, and then send out the mails or whatever message you want to, you know, send out to that employee from whom you want referral, right? And make sure that you give him the job ID. Don't just coldly text him that, hey, is there any active openings in the company, or are you aware of any openings? Because most likely it's not going to work out, because try to understand this thing. He's an employee of the company, he's not a recruiter. So it might happen he's not aware of the openings in the company, right? And if you're directly texting a recruiter, then you can definitely directly text him or her that, hey, is there any opening in the company? But if you're asking for a referral from some random employee, right, then make sure that you have the job ID ready with you, right? So that's very, very important. Now that's the first point. Now step two is, don't apply till the time the person refers you. Please remember this. A lot of students have a confusion regarding this. If you first apply and then ask that person to refer you for that same job ID, that person won't be able to, right? Because try to understand this. If you're asking for referrals, you can't apply to that job directly, right? I mean, definitely you can directly apply, but once you have directly applied, the referral for that particular job ID is not valid, right? So you have to understand this. If you wish to take a referral for that particular job ID, what you need to do is, instead of directly applying first, you need to first note down his job ID, ask for a referral, and after the person has referred you, within 2 or 3 working days — by working days I mean I don't include Saturdays and Sundays — let's say a person, an employee, referred you on Friday, right? And since I told you that 2 to 3 working days, it should be, I think Saturday, Sunday won't be included in this counting, and you would get, you know, your probably your referral mail that this person has referred you. Now kindly go and fill up the application details by Wednesday and Thursday. So I've understood by now that you would get a mail where you would get notifications that, hey, this person has agreed to refer you to your company. Now you would find the application link. Now click on that application link, fill in your details, and then only apply. Again, I repeat, reiterate this. Don't go and apply first, right? First ask for referral. Then you would get a mail, right, from the company sending you a notification that, hey, this person X has referred you for this role. Then you would go to that particular, and they would send you an application link in the mail itself. You would go to the application link, fill your all your details, right? Some of the details will already show up, which the employee has or the referrer has filled up for you, right? And then go and apply. Then your application is complete. So again, I'm reiterating this. Don't apply first if you want a referral for that position. First, take note of the job ID. That is the step one, right? Now send the job ID to the referrer, and along with it, write some few lines about you, that why you are a good fit for that role, and your CV, right? And then once that person refers you, wait for 2 or 3 working days, right? And then you would get a referral mail, right? And in that referral mail, you will have the application link. So click on that application link and then fill your application details, and then only apply. One thing to keep in mind over here is that once the employer has referred you, right, don't go and badger around him that, hey, when I'm going to get the mail, why am I not getting calls? Because that person's job is only to refer you. Once that person has referred you, he doesn't normally get any update about your application process. It then goes to the hands of the recruiter. So more likely, the chances are that the referrer person might not have any idea about your application status. So it's not a good thing to do, you know, just to keep on texting your referrer, right, who has referred you to that particular company and asking for the application update, right? Also, please note that a referral doesn't guarantee you a interview call from that particular company, right? Referral, I feel, is a very overrated thing. If you have a good profile, you can still go and apply directly. Let's say no one is referring you, right? You are not able to get referrals. Then I would highly suggest you go and apply directly, right? Referrals are definitely a good way or a positive thing, but it doesn't guarantee an interview call. So don't be under this notion that if someone is referring me, then I'm going to get a call sure shot. Right, referral is not a magic wand. If your CV is good, even if you apply directly, you would get calls. I have seen numerous instances. And also sometimes what happens is even the recruiters reaches out to you directly. You don't even need to apply. I would tell you a short anecdote from my journey, right? So I applied to Amazon 6 to 7 times for referrals. I never got a call, right? And after a few days, I got a call directly from the recruiter for some different positions where I never even applied for, right? So getting my point. So if your CV is good, if your profile seems good, and if the recruiter, right, if the recruiter or a particular recruiter of that particular company. I try to understand this, there are a lot of recruiters, right? Some recruiters would love your profile, some might not. Or like, there would be some positions, right, that might fit you, or there would be some positions that you might not be a good fit, right? Because it's a large, these companies are mostly large tech companies, right? So there would be a lot of roles and a lot of openings, right? So try to understand this, that if you have a good profile, then even if you apply directly, you would get a call. And if you have a bad profile, even if you get a referral, that is not going to help your cause, right? So referrals does not act as a magic wand. It's at the end of the day, it all boils down to how you have built up your resume and your profile. That's something very important, and I want to plant this idea in your head. Now I'm going to give you one very common trick which I think most of you miss. See, if you're applying for Amazon, right, or let's say if you're applying for Microsoft and you want to apply for SD1 position, right, or any other companies, let's just say, right, so there would be multiple openings for SE1 or software SD1, right? So what I've generally seen people doing is they apply to one particular role or take referral for one particular role. Don't do that. Apply to multiple job openings, right, or apply to multiple job IDs, or because what happens is that increases your probability. Because let's say that you want to apply at Microsoft, right? So then Microsoft, you have this team A that is based in Bangalore, you have this team B based in Hyderabad, right? And let's say you saw that there is an opening for team A for your position, and you took a referral, right, and you applied for it and you're waiting for the call, but the call never arrived, right? But instead of doing that, if you had applied for the team A based out in Bangalore and also team B based out in Bangalore, let's say you didn't get a referral for that. Let's say you applied directly, right? But it might happen that the recruiter who is managing team A, right, might not like your profile, but the recruiter B who is managing your managing team B, right, might like your profile and it might give you an interview chance. So you have to increase your probability. Also, it might happen that there were so many applications to that team A that your resume got missed. There can be so many things, right? I mean, a lot of applications are being sent out to these companies each day. So you have to increase your probability of getting interview calls. So that is the reason I would highly encourage you to go and apply to multiple job IDs. Even if you are not getting referrals for all the job IDs, then please, please make sure to apply directly. It's not going to cost you a thing, right? So this is a very common trick I've seen people missing, right? They feel that if they've applied for a particular job ID, they can't apply to other job IDs. No, you can still apply to other job IDs, right? And there will be a lot of other job IDs. Like, let's say if I'm taking Microsoft, they are having, I think, in 3 or 4 locations. Even in the same location, even in Bangalore, you can have openings across multiple teams. So even in Bangalore, because you can apply to 3 or 4 teams and you can take referrals for that, right? So that's the way it works. It's not that if you're applying for one particular job ID, you can't apply to the other job IDs within that same particular company. I would highly encourage you to go and apply for multiple job IDs in the same company. That way, you increase your chance of getting an interview call, right? Getting an interview call. Now I will share some common tips and tricks. This was one trick I already mentioned about. Other thing is how to get hold of job IDs. So that is something that you need to do yourself. So you have to go and visit the career website. You have to keep checking the company websites and you have to search for the job IDs and the relevant job IDs. Don't waste your time by applying to job IDs where you yourself know you are not going to be a fit, right? So take a note of the job IDs. Try to reach out to recruiters directly, right? If that does not happen, try to reach out to employees, ask for referral, and even if you are not unable to get a referral, just go and apply directly, right? But make sure you have a proper CV and you are well prepared, right? Also, I have set up a Telegram group, right, where I try to post all the hiring updates I come across. So if there are any openings in my team or in some other company, I normally try to notify you in the Telegram group. So make sure to join that group also, which you can find in the description down below. Also, another last question is, a lot of you complain that I'm asking for referrals to so many people, but none of them seem to refer me, right? Or they are not even replying back. So I would give you a very nice tactic that works for me, right? So normally, let's say if you want to apply for Microsoft, right? Or let's say you want to apply for Google, right? So let's say if you want to apply for Microsoft, right? And the first thing that would come to your mind from whom you want to like ask for reference is some famous YouTuber, right? Or some famous person that you already know. But I would highly suggest you, or I would highly discourage you to do that, because let's pick a very famous YouTuber from Microsoft, right? Or let's pick a very famous YouTuber from Google, right? And if you, or let's say he's very famous on LinkedIn, right? Something like that. And if you go and ask him to refer you, what happens is, and the reason I'm saying this is because I've seen people making this mistake, right? But don't do this. Why I'm telling you is, see, if you go to that person, try to understand, this is a very famous person, right? So he might be getting a lot of similar requests from other guys as well. So there is very, very less chance that he is going to like even come across your test and read your text and your request, right? Because he might be getting a lot of other types of requests as well, not only reference. So you have to understand that you cannot go to any famous person and ask him, like famous as in on famous on LinkedIn, YouTube, some person, famous, I mean some person who usually gets a lot of DMs, right, across various platforms. So don't usually reach out to those persons, because the probability is very less that they're going to refer you, right? Because it's not possible for a single person to go over all the DMs and refer all the people. It's not possible, right? And the second thing is, don't take it as a rule of thumb. Again, whatever I'm saying is just a suggestion. Take it with a pinch of salt. But again, what I would suggest is, don't go to persons who are like, let's say, who are senior most person, right? Try to go to the persons who are junior and who had a similar background as you, as of you, right? In that way, it makes more sense to get a referral. And also, one thing I always suggest folks is, let's say you want to get a job at Google, right? You want to like get a referral at Google, and suddenly you see that on LinkedIn someone posted that I got into Google, right? So what you would do is, you know that this person recently got into Google, right? And when a person recently joins a company, in the first two, three weeks, what happens is he doesn't have much work to do. Mostly he goes through the onboarding process, training process and all these things. And trust me, these guys have a lot of free time, right? Most of them, right? So what happens is, they like, and also they are posting things on LinkedIn. So go and approach them and ask for a referral, because they have just joined the company, they don't have much work to do, they are in a good mood, and they are most likely to refer you if they like your profile, right? Instead of going for a very senior person who's working at Google, he might be busy in his own task, in his day-to-day activities, and he might not end up, and might end up not seeing your message. So these are the very common things, tricks that I think you should follow if once you want to get a referral, right? Also, if you want to reach out to the recruiter directly, you can do a random search. That also helps on LinkedIn. Or what you can do is, you will come across various such posts where, you know, when a person joins a company, normally gives a token of gratitude to the recruiter and tags him or her, right, in the same post itself. So from that you can come to know, and then you can like follow the recruiter, message him, right, or mail him whatever is convenient for you and her as well. So in that way you can also come across like multiple job openings, and that can open up a lot of avenues for you, right? So it's all about being aware, being in present in the situation, and be prepared. That is very important. Referrals do not act as a magic wand, and that is something I really, really want to emphasize on in this video, right? I hope that I was able to clear all the doubts, or at least most of the doubts that you guys have surrounding referrals. If you still have any doubt, then don't hesitate to comment it down below. I would be more than happy to resolve all the doubts for you guys. But just take an informed decision, right? Don't think referral is something that would definitely get an interview call. It's not like that. And if you had liked this video, if it had, you know, provided some value or some content to you, then don't forget to press the like button. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Please help me in reaching the 20,000 subscribers, and that would really, really motivate a lot. You can join my Telegram group. As I mentioned, I keep on posting the hiring updates over there. You can follow me on Instagram if you want to have any one-to-one conversations with me, or if you have any, if you want any guidance, I would be more than happy to help you out. And also, you can also follow me on LinkedIn, where I post a lot of stuff regarding tech and software engineering. So having said that, it's time to end this video and bid adieu to you guys. I would come up with some other more informative videos. I also I'm teaching graph, right? So you can go and check out my graph placement playlist, and I'm taking live classes. So I would attach the link to the videos and the playlist in the description down below, and also in the Telegram group I will be posting out whenever I will be having these live classes, right? So goodbye, stay safe, and thank you so much.